The levator palpebris superioris has an origin on the lesser wing of the sphenoid anterior to the optic canal, and it inserts on the anterior dorsal plate. The action of this muscle is elevation of the upper lid. The superior rectus muscle is directly underneath the levator palpebris superioris. The superior rectus muscle has an origin on the superior part of the tendinous ring and inserts on the superior anterior half of the eyeball. The superior rectus muscle elevates, adducts, and medially rotates the eyeball. The medial rectus muscle has an origin on the medial side of the commissural tendinous ring behind the optic nerve, which is right over here, and inserts on the medial anterior half of the eyeball. The medial rectus muscle adducts the eyeball. The inferior rectus muscle has an origin on the inferior part of the common tendinous ring and inserts on the inferior anterior half of the eyeball. The inferior rectus muscle depresses, adducts, and laterally rotates the eyeball. The medial rectus muscle has an origin on the medial side of the commissural tendinous ring behind the optic nerve, which is right over here, and inserts on the medial anterior half of the eyeball. The medial rectus muscle adducts the eyeball. The superior oblique muscle has an origin on the body of the sphenoid anterior and medial to the optic canal. You can see the fibers going over here to the medial superior corner of the orbit, going through a tendinous slip, then changing directions and attaching to the posterior quadrant of the eyeball. The superior oblique muscle depresses the eyeball, abducts the eyeball, and medially rotates the eyeball. The inferior oblique muscle has an origin on the medial floor of the orbit, posterior to the rim of the maxilla, and lateral to the nasolacrimal groove. It inserts on the outer posterior quadrant of the eyeball. The inferior oblique elevates, abducts, and laterally rotates the eye.